Hello friends, welcome to Susanna and John MathTube. In this video, we're going to talk about the Cauchy-Riemann equation in polar form. In video number one, when we did that revision in complex numbers, we learned that every complex number x plus iy in the Cartesian form can be converted into r e power I theta. And we even learned a trick to find the values of r and theta really fast. We need that because soon we'll be learning complex integration. At that point, such techniques are extremely important. Anyway, imagine we have a problem like f of z equal to z to the power 9. Do you remember? We proved that f of z equal to z square is analytic using CR equation. We even proved that f of z equal to z cube is analytic. But in your exam, imagine they are going to ask, prove that f of z equal to z power 9 is analytic. Now I'll guarantee that you will not like the Cartesian method. Because look at this, I have to write this as u plus iv equal to x plus iy the whole power 9. Now, you might be thinking, you remember binomial theorem from your high school? But wait a minute, when we had x plus iy the whole square, we had only 3 terms. Even here we had only 4 terms, but now we are going to have 10 terms. If you love that method, it's up to you. Anyway, I am not going to do this method. So imagine we have to prove that f of z equal to z to the power n is analytic. So what I'm going to do is, instead of the Cartesian form, I'm going to convert our function into r e power I theta the whole power n. By the way, in case you don't know what is r, what is theta, pause the video right now and watch the revision. In revision, I have clearly explained what is the polar form of a complex number. Anyway, those who are okay with this, let's continue. U plus iv is equal to r power n e power I theta the whole power n. In case you are confused, AB the whole power n is a power n multiplied by b power n. And a power n the whole power n will be a power n multiplied by m. Anyway, eventually I am going to get u plus iv equal to r power n e to the power I n theta. Now, what is e power I theta? Think about it. It is sys theta or cos theta plus I sin theta. So our function reduces to r power n multiplied by cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So you can distribute this r power n. Just take it inside. Take it inside. So we are going to get u equal to r power n cos n theta, v is equal to r power n sin n theta. So once more, let me try to explain. We have z to the power 10, z to the power 100, like that in general, z to the power n. So I did not apply the Cartesian method, I converted it into polar form. And I found u and v. Now look at this. In Cartesian form, our equation was ux is equal to vy and uy equal to minus vx. What do you call these equations? Yeah, CR equation, Cauchy-Riemann equation. Now I cannot use this. I cannot use this because I got u and v in terms of r and theta, the polar variables. So the polar version goes like this. You have to find ur and vr. Ur means partial derivative with respect to r. Remember, in polar form, r and theta are the heroes. There is no x and y. And you prove that this is equal to 1 by r v theta. And you prove that this is equal to minus 1 by r u theta. So, let's find u r. What do you mean by u r? U r means r is the only variable, or in other words, this part is a constant. So, I'm going to get n r power n minus 1 and I'll leave the constant as such. If you didn't understand, I'll try to explain. How do you differentiate 5 into r power n? You'll keep 5 as such. So, the green stuff is a constant. I'm keeping that constant and differentiating the remaining part. Now, let's go for vr. What is vr? Similarly, n r power n minus 1 sine n theta, because theta is a constant. Now u theta means who's the variable? Theta. So r power n is a constant. Derivative of cos is minus sine multiplied by n. And v theta similarly will be r power n cos n theta multiplied by n. Now let's confirm it. U r, I'll color it for you. I'll use red color. U r and v theta. Are they connected by this relation? I hope yes. You confirm it yourself. And I'll color it with blue. V r and u theta. So if you confirmed it, that's it. So, the partial derivatives are continuous, trigonometric, polynomial, etc., etc. Also, the CR equation. Look at this. This is the CR equation in polar coordinate system, not this one. Not this one, so please note it down. So, you can write it like this. The Cauchy-Riemann equation in polar system is UR equal to this, VR equal to this. Okay. Now, one more thing. Suppose you want to find the derivative of the function. As I always tell you, the derivative of real valued function and the complex valued functions are the same. Somehow it became the same. So I know the derivative is n z to the power n minus 1. But if you want to find it with the help of the CR equation, the formula in polar coordinate system is e power minus I theta u r plus I v r. So that will be e power minus I theta u r is, can you see the red one, n r power n minus 1 cos n theta plus I into n r power n minus 1 sine n theta. So we get common n r power n minus 1 e power minus I theta into cos n theta plus I sine n theta, and that will be n r power n minus 1 e power minus I theta into e power I n theta. I hope you still remember the Euler's value, and we get n r power n minus 1. You combine this. What is a power m times a power n? A power m plus n. So e power minus I theta e power I n theta, we will get e power minus I theta plus I n theta, and that will be I theta is common, so e power I theta into n minus 1. So I'm going to combine this n r e power I theta the whole power n minus 1, and this will be n z to the power n minus 1. Do you remember? Our z is r e power I theta. Let's do another problem. Anyway, the last part is not that important, but in some universities, especially in the Bangalore University, Anna University, etc., in India, this part is like extra important. Anyway, another question. Suppose they ask you, prove that log z is analytic if z is not equal to 0. Now look at this. If you write log a plus b, we will get stuck because there is no property for log a plus b. If it is log a plus log b, I am happy there is a property. If it is log a multiplied by b, yes, there is a property, but there is no property for log a plus b. And I am telling you so that you don't invent a new property. Log x plus iy does not have a standard property. So our Cartesian method will not be of any help here. So I start u plus iv. I hope you remember the method. Log, what should I write instead of z? R e power I theta. That is u plus iv equal to, what is log a into b? Log a plus log b. What is log a to the power b? Come on, come on, come on, come on. What is log a to the power b? B log a. So this becomes u plus iv equal to log r. This jumps I theta log e. Wow, we got log e. Log e means 1. So this part will vanish and we get u equal to log r, v is equal to theta. Now, do you remember the polar version? U r, v r. Then you write 1 by r minus 1 by r. And here I'll write v theta, here I'll write u theta. This is how I remember the Cauchy-Riemann equation in polar system. So let me find u r, so 1 by r. Let me find v r, that will be 0. U theta will be 0. V theta will be equal to 1. Now I'll color it in blue. U r is 1 by r. Yeah. So it's verified. That's it. Now let's go for one more problem. Prove that. Like what you call, you might remember this question. We did the same question in the last video. So what we do is, we will write u plus iv equal to, if you want, you can do it like 1 by x plus iy, but the calculation will become very long. Anyway, I love this method. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to convert it into polar form. Polar form means, we will assume z equal to x plus, no. We will assume z equal to r e power I theta. And by the way, z is not equal to 0. So u plus iv equal to 1 by r. 1 by a means a power minus 1. So this will go to the numerator. And u plus iv equal to 1 by r cos theta minus I sine theta. So u equal to, just distribute it, 1 by r cos theta. And v equal to minus 1 by r sine theta. Okay, before we continue, let me ask you one question. What is the derivative of 1 by x? Come on. What is the derivative of 1 by x? Minus 1 by x squared. So I'm going to find ur. Ur means r is the variable. That means cos theta is a constant. So I'm going to get minus 1 by r squared cos theta. Now vr will be 1 by r squared cos theta. 1 by r squared sine theta, because sine theta will be a constant. Now u theta means theta is the hero, so 1 by r is a constant, so minus sine theta. And v theta will be equal to minus 1 by r cos theta. Now you can verify it. So that's it. That is a small video, but this is like very important, because in many universities I have seen so many times, they keep on asking, prove that z to the power n is analytic and log z is analytic. So these questions are very important, and you will not be able to do these questions with the help of Cartesian form. So I'll be back with another video. So till then, my friends, bye.